Phillips curve depicts a negative relationship between inflation rate and unemployment rate. Suppose we start our initial equilibrium with the potential output Y star, and our price P star is corresponding to our target inflation rate pi star, let's say 2%. And at this point, our unemployment rate is at the natural rate of unemployment. Now, suppose there is an economic expansion which shifts our aggregate demand curve from 80 star to 82. As a result, price level goes up and our output also goes up. So you can see that when our real GDP is higher than its potential, that means our unemployment rate is lower than the natural rate of unemployment. So our new unemployment rate is at U2. U2 is lower than NRU. At the same time, our inflation rate has increased from pi star to pi 2. Let's say inflation rate goes up from 2% to 6%. If there is a recession, that will cause our aggregate demand curve to shift to the left. As a result, price level goes down and output goes down. Our new output level Y1 is lower than the potential output, meaning we will have cyclical unemployment. So our current unemployment level, U1, is higher than the natural rate of unemployment. At the same time, price level goes down from P star to P1, and our inflation rate also goes down from pi star to pi 1, let's say from 2% to 1%. Here is the bottom line of Phillips curve. There is a trade-off between inflation rate and unemployment rate. Either we have high inflation rate and low unemployment rate, or we have low inflation rate and high unemployment rate. Remember, in economics, there is always a trade-off.